Hello student,
as the continuation of the video lecture, this is the next part of class 10, chapter number 2, that is, chapter number 4, heredity, okay, is the next and last part, because here we will discuss, firstly we will discuss about the Mendel's law, but I suggest you, before seeing this video, go through the previous video, that is part 1 of heredity, okay. And see that process, what are the cross are present there, dihybrid cross, monohybrid cross, okay. But first you go through that, after that you see this video, okay. So here the first thing you know about that Mendel's law. Mendel was given three laws. The first law is called as law of dominance. In some book it was just deleted, but you have to know, if you are preparing for competitive, then this law is important. Second law is law of segregation. It is also called as law of purity of gamut. Okay, and the third law is basically law of independent DENT assortment. So first we'll discuss about law of dominance. As I already told you, the monohybrid cross, just think about the monohybrid cross. What you have to do, number one thing is that you have to just cross with a tall plant with a dwarf plant. Tall, that is capital T, you have to cross with small t. This generation is parental generation, or a zero generation. Okay, parental generation or a zero generation. If we are crossing that, okay, we will find the capital T and small t. So all the plants are tall. So this one is F1 generation. This one is what? F1 generation. So simply the first law is what, when we cross two TWO, two homozygous alleles, then in F1 generation the character which was shown called dominant character, and the character which was repressed by dominant called recessive character. Okay, so this one is the first law. This one is just not find your any book, but in NCERT it was given two or three lines. It was given about that. Okay, this is the first law. Now come to the next slide. The next slide, that is law of segregation. So in this slide we are going to discuss about the second law, that is law of segregation. Segregation is separation, or it is also called as purity of gamut. Means pure gamut means only the homozygous alleles are pure gametes. Okay, so in this law, what you have to do, the second, that is the F2 generation, you will find that monohybrid plus F2 generation, simply simply they did tall plant cross with a dwarf plant. So will there is capital T, small t, this one is P generation, yeah, parental generation or F1 generation. Okay, after crossing we will find that capital T small t is not pure, that is hybrid, that is finding the F1 generation. If we are going into the F2 generation, we will do selfing means self cross or self pollination. So we will find that after formation of gamete, capital T small t, if we are crossing it, we will find capital T small t. So this one is the F2 generation. So we will find the phenotypic ratio. If you find the phenotypic ratio, that is 3:1, and genotypic ratio is that 1:2:1. Okay, so this is the second law. You always in your mind, this one is the second law. Okay, come to the third law is totally that is law of independent assortment, is totally depend on the dihybrid cross. It's totally a dihybrid cross. Okay, the third one, law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment. Okay, so in this law, that is dihybrid cross is there. Suppose that capital T capital R, that is tall and round, we will cross with small t smaller. So in F1 generation, capital T small t capital R smaller, this one is P generation, that is F0 generation, parental generation, or this one is F1 generation. Okay, we will find that F2 generation, we will do selfing. Okay, capital T small t capital R smaller, and we are doing the branching. So you will find this branching, okay, in dihybrid cross. So dihybrid cross is this dihybrid cross, that F2 generation, that in 9:3:3:1 is important one. Okay, whatever the things you will find, there is checkerboard, Punnett square. Dihybrid cross is totally on the law of independent assortment. Independent assortment means easily it was grown. Independent assortment means some other types of species will find this. Okay, so this is the law of Mendel's, that is simply the Mendel's law. Okay, so Mendel's law is this one. Okay, the second thing and the most important things, that is you have to just in class 8 you know about sex determination in human being. Sex determination in human being. Okay, as I know that, okay, suppose that a male, that is, this is the sign of male and female, that is, this one is the female have also, that is 46 chromosome, and female have also 46 chromosome. In 46 chromosome we will write that 23 pair. Here we will also write that 23 pair. In that 23 pair, in male, 22 pair are same, but one pair, that is X and Y, are different. Here also 22 pair are same, and the second one, that is XX, that is a different. So male have a different sex chromosome, but not female. So only male are having responsibility for the determination of the sex of a baby. Okay, so this 22 pair of chromosomes is called as autosome or somatic chromosome. Okay, and these two, that is XY and XX, are called as sex chromosome or allosome. So this one is the important part, because suppose the question is arise that which chromosome does not participate in the determination of the sex of a baby. The simple you write that is autosome or somatic chromosome does not participate in the determination of sex of a baby. It only had to give the physical appearance of a baby rather than sex. And the sex chromosome or the allosome was only and only responsible for the determination of the sex of a baby, whatever the baby's sex. Okay? So in the next slide, in this slide, we have to know about the process. Suppose that here is a male, okay, and it will be crossed with a female. Suppose that here is a male and it was crossed with a female. Okay, so male have 46 chromosomes, so we will write that 23 pair. Here also we will write that 46 chromosomes, that is 23 pair. Okay, so before writing this, we will write it 22 pair plus XY. And here we will write 22 pair plus XX. So before starting, we will do that. First we will do the gamete formation. The gamete we will form, 122 is combined with X and another 22 is combined with Y. And here also, 122 is combined with X and another 22 is combined with X. If we do crossing, so this cross with this, the 22 pair plus XX. This one, 22 pair plus XX. Here, 22 pair plus XY. Here, 22 pair plus XY. Okay, so in 50-50% chances, that is, whether it was male or female, this one is a female, this one is female, okay, and this one is the male, okay. So in that 50-50% chances, there is the formation of male and female. So this is all about the heredity part. Okay, so thank you.